Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.1, Problem 7. This is Section 2.1, Problem number 7. It says the frequency table below shows where the students in a Math 119 class live. Make a pie chart for this data. So this seems like it's probably a pretty typical class. We have Fall River, 12 of the students come from Fall River, New Bedford, 6 students are from New Bedford, there are 3 from Westport, and 3 from Dartmouth. So we're gonna make a pie chart or, you know, a circle graph, and what we wanna figure out first of all is how many students altogether are in this class. So if we added up 12 and 6 is 18, 18 plus 3 is 21, 21 and 3 more is 24. So we have a total of 24 students. So 12 out of 24 is 1/2 or 50% of the students come from Fall River. Then the next group, 6, are from New Bedford. So 6 over 24 is 1/4 or 0.25. And again, I see this very easily. If you don't, on your calculator, just divide, 6 divided by 24 equals, and the calculator will tell you it's 0.25 or 25%. And Westport, 3 over 24, that one's not as obvious. It's half of the 25%, so it would be 0.125. Again, if it's not something that's intuitive to you, just with your calculator, divide the top, the how many people just from Westport, divided by the total in the class, and the calculator will tell you it's 0.125, which means 12.5%. Dartmouth's going to be the same percentage. So I want these percents to see how much of my pie chart I dedicate to each town or city. So I'll start with a circle. I've got a pretty good circle there. You can certainly trace something if you want. Of course, Microsoft Word and Excel have an option for drawing pie charts for you. What you want to do is go to the menu on the top. The second or third one in says Insert. When you go to that Insert menu, one of them will be Charts and Graphs, and then one of the many options for charts and graphs would be a pie chart. And you can do a two-dimensional one or a three-dimensional one if you want. Pretty easy to do. They set one up for you that's pretty standard. It has 4 categories, but you can add more easily. And they have standard labels already, which you can change very easily, too. It's easy to do, and it'll give it different colors. Very nice. So anyway, to draw it freehand, the Fall River students account for 50% of the class, so it should be 50% of my pie chart. So I'll split it pretty much down the center. I'll label this segment of the pie chart with Fall River, and I'll put a percentage, 50%. Half the class is from Fall River, which is probably pretty realistic. The next group of students, New Bedford, is going to count for 1/4 or 25% of the class. Again, some classes it might be more, it might be less. This is a particular made-up class for the sake of this problem. So if 1/4 of the class is from New Bedford, 1/4 of my graph should be represented by New Bedford. And then the last two towns will split up the rest of the circle at 12.5% each. So the remaining 25% chunk of my circle, I'm going to split it in half. It's pretty close to half. One of them being Westport. At 12.5% of the class. And the other one is Dartmouth. I'll write that on a bit of a slant to make it fit more easily. Also 12.5%. If your wedges in your pie chart get kind of small, and sometimes they do, you can just write it outside the circle and put a little arrow pointing to that wedge and along with the percentage. It's very common. And you can check the percents. It does add up to 100%, which it does need to do for a pie chart.